Now, I'm going to go over one more thing, and that would be that there was a question. How do you know whether you have to use parentheses or not use parentheses? Like, for example, if I do here get num rows, do I have to do parentheses after that or not? So an easy answer for this is if I go here and do dot, and you see there is this purple icon sticking next to it, that means it's a method. So if it's a method, then you're going to have to use this parentheses after that. Now let's see if that same thing has anything that's not a method. So let's scroll down and find out. Now this one doesn't have it. Anything here, you can see this icon, it's a method. So you would have to use open close parentheses right there. But let's go on the spreadsheet app and hit dot and see if this has anything. So see here, we have this purple ones right here. These are all methods. That means with parentheses. And if we scroll up, see like this autofill series, it's not one of those icons like this. So it's not a method. So that means for this one, you would not do parentheses. So that's just a property. And on that, you might have other things. So if I do dot, see now I have, see this is also not that purple thing. So again, it's not a method. So that would be just this. So the quick answer to that, without really understanding the underlying difference between methods and properties, is that. Now, as far as in general, let's just go over and add a script. I'm just going to call it object, I guess. I know people sometimes get really irritated when they come from different programming languages and you call this thing an object, but I'm going to do it anyways. So generally speaking, if you create a JavaScript object, we'll call this object a cell. And this cell will be an object. So within this cell, we can have different properties of that cell. So for example, we can say color is red. And then I can do comma and do like value of the cell is 45, something like that. So if I wanted now to access that color and value, I would do cell dot, see color and value. And these are called properties. So you can see how that purple icon doesn't show up. So that means if I wanted to get that red or that value, I would just simply do this because it's actually a property. So let's just do console log so you can see how this works. So if I go back and run this thing that's called my function, now this is not any more triggered execution, so we can see this here. So you can see this is red, right? So now, if I go inside of this object, I can actually create a function in this object, like this. Let's call this function getValue. I guess let's make it similar to how spreadsheets sort of work, like this. And that would be a function. And in this function, let's return something. So I'm going to return 55, like this. So now this is a function, and this is a property, as you can see, because it's not a function aligned to this. So that means that if I now wanted to get that, use that get value thing that I have there, then the way that would work, it would be that same cell dot, and then you would do get value, and this should be a function. So let's try this and see if this works. And it does. See, I got that 55, which is that value of this. So because this is a function within that object, then we have to use those parentheses here, right there. And this color, it's not a function within that object. So therefore, I don't know how I get this dots all the time, but there should be no dots, like this. So then here, there is no parentheses. So that's the real answer of why you may or may not have those parentheses. One is a property, the other one is basically a function. How would you use classes in AppScript? I don't know, are you asking why you would use it or how you would use it? Because why, it's a little difficult question to answer, but like if you were doing like basic scripts, you would probably not use classes. But if you just want to create a class, so if I wanted to replicate this maybe, so I could create like a class, and let's actually get this outside of this, and create a class called cell. And here you could have some sort of constructor that runs. So constructor is the first function that's going to run when you instantiate this. For example, you might want to set some of those things that we had before. So for example, if you remember, I had like the color. So I would say this color red, and this refers to the instance of this object. It's kind of a complicated topic to just explain what this means, but basically for anything you set on that object, it's going to start with this. So I would say this color, this value equals, let's say 45, something like that. And then we could have functions within this too. So if you remember, I had that get value function. So here, notice that when I create a function, I don't put the word function in front of it. I just do this to do the get value. And we can return, let's say 55. Something like this. So this would be the class way of doing that same thing I just went through a second ago. For a class to work, we have to basically instantiate the class. So what that means is that I can go to my function here and use this class cell now. So I can say const my cell, create a variable, equals new cell. And because I'm not passing any arguments in this function, then we're not going to pass anything here in this parentheses. And this my cell at this point will be that object. And you can see now that autocomplete is very similar to how that autocomplete works when we work with that internal stuff we have. So see, this color now would refer to this red. So if I do console.log color, that should now, if I run this function, that should now return that red. And if I wanted to use that get value function, then again, you would use this because it's a function, it goes with parentheses. And that's, if I run this, see, this is red, this is 55, right there. So the way this works is that once you do this new cell, this my cell variable that you create essentially becomes this. So this at that point is this my cell. Once I do this, and we're saying now in this my cell, let's add a dot color and make it red, and then dot value and make it 45. And this is what that this will refer to, this instance of that particular object. Now you could create multiple objects using the same, what we call constructor, at the same time, other cell, like so. And now this other cell would be its own instance of that object, and it will have its own this color, this value. So now we have this that refers that this now here, first time refers to this. And then for this other cell, again, that would be this too. So basically it allows us to reuse all of this code for both of these in the same manner while we have them as separate objects. And that will allow us to change things in these objects and things like that. So maybe we want to add like set value here function. So what we can do, maybe we want to change this value here, right? Using the set value. So I can get that value, whatever that argument is going to be. I'm just going to call it V. And then I can take this internal value of this object and set it to be that V that was passed in this function right there. And now what that means is that I have a way to change what the value here is. Now, let's actually get rid of this for a second here and get rid of this color. And for now, let's just look at this value. And remember, this value is not this, it's this. It's dot value because it's the property, that 45. So if I run this, that gives me 45, right? But now what we can do, we can use that function set value on this my cell to change that value. So let's say I want it to now become 77. So now if I do that console log in the next line after this, save this and run, my cell is not defined. Did I misspell it? Of course I did. It's a uppercase C, not lowercase. Save this. Rerun this again. See, it was 45, now it's 77. So initially, it was 45 here. Then we can use now this set value function here to modify what this internal value 45 is using this set value over here. And we can change our get value, for example, instead of returning that 45 to actually return the value. So we can say return this dot value. And this way, now we should be able to use that get value instead of just value to get the value of that. Property. So these would be our methods. These are our properties, basically. And right now, I'm not using any of the properties. I'm just using methods to set and get the value. So if I run this, you can see we should get the same thing. 45, then we change it. Now it's 77. So that's the gist of it, of how you would create an object. I guess one thing that's worth to mention here is that when you create this constructor, you may want to just pass some things by default. So let's say you want this default value instead of being 45 to be whatever you give it when you create this and the color. So we can just go here and do something like two arguments in this constructor. We can do like color. Actually, let's just call it C so it's not confusing. Just one, the color and V. So now we have these two arguments, which we can pass here. We can pass like black and make it by default to be like 32, something like this. So what we can do here, instead of making this red here, we can just make it this argument that we pass here to be the C. And then this one would be this argument we pass here to be V. So that means when we instantiate this object, when we create it, it will make the color here black and this to be 32. And then again, we can get that value and we can set that value to 77. Later. So if I run this, you'll see it's 32 to begin with, then we modify it to 77. So that's the way you can pass arguments directly to this constructor too, if you want.